How do you find this paper? Easy or difficult? This paper, I'm not going to touch the passage first. The first 10 questions, what do they deal with? Passage. We'll start with not the passage, after the passage. Please go to questions 11 to 15. In each of the following sentences, there's a blank space followed by some choices of words given in options. You have to determine which of these words fits well in all, making them meaningful and grammatically correct. Word can be modified. Please underline that part. Word can be modified according to the tense of the sentence, keeping the meaning of root word intact. Meaning should not change. Okay. Shall I read the first one? Question number 11, what is it? He made of corruption against the administration. Not easy to make out, leave that one. The police are investigating that the mayor has accepted bribes. So what is the word you have to think of? Investigating what? Allegation, accusation, charge, all these. What is the third one? You are making a serious, do you have any proof? Again, you can think of the word allegation or accusation. But what is the problem with this question? Do you think something is missing? What is missing? The indefinite article an is missing. With the assumption it is there, what is the first sentence? He made an allegation. Please write that way. He made an allegation of corruption against the administration. You could also use a definite article. He made the allegation of corruption, or he made the allegation against the administration. Right. The police are investigating an allegation that the mayor has accepted bribes. Investigating what? An allegation. Right. You are making a serious allegation. This is perfect. No disturbance as such. You are making a serious allegation. Do you have any proof? So what is the answer based on that? The third option is the answer. But sometimes we use this word in the plural form. The police are investigating the allegations, the accusations. It could be singular, it could be plural. Shall I move on to the next one? What is the question number 12? This is rather easy. Down the road, he could see a bus coming from the opposite what? Direction. Hold that one. Excuse me, could you please give me what? Direction to movie theater. These discoveries have given a new direction to their research. So what is the answer here? We'll check other options. Previous one also, have we checked the other options? Let us check the other options. He made a report, but generally what do you say? He made a report of corruption, that is right. The police are investigating a report that the mayor has accepted bribes, that also seems right. You are making a serious report, is it right? No. Because of the third sentence, mark this wrong. He made a file of corruption, seems acceptable. The police are investigating a file of corruption would have been right. A file that the mayor has accepted bribes. Let us consider that also. You are making a serious file. Is it right? And preposition into. You are making a serious into. Is it right? Last one is what? He made a statement of corruption. Seems okay. The police are investigating statement that the mayor has accepted bribes, perhaps. You are making a serious statement. Do you have any proof? But serious statement is not correct. Serious accusation, serious allegation. So you got all the five options. Now we'll see question number 12, other options. Down the road, you could see a bus coming from the opposite move. Is it right? Mark it wrong. opposite, from the opposite way. Seems acceptable. Excuse me, could you please give me a way to the movie theater? Is it right? No. And side road, from the opposite road, seems right. Could you please give me a road to the movie theater? Not right. Could you give me side to the movie theater? Not right. So what is the answer here? Fifth option. Question number 13. In this, we were able to save enough money for a new car. Now, in this company, seems okay. In this regard, seems okay. In this way, that is also right. In this manner, seems right. In this nature, usually we don't say, manner seems appropriate. We'll see the second sentence. What is it? It was her energetic and friendly company. Seems right. Regard, is it right? Mark the second one wrong. The second option doesn't go with the second sentence. It was her energetic and friendly way. Seems right. This church was built in the way of, is it right? In the way of is not correct. Mark it wrong. Now we'll see the fourth one. In this manner, we were able to save enough money for a new car. Seems right. It was her energetic and friendly manner that got her the job, right? This church was built in the manner of, that is also right, in the manner of what? The English Gothic style. Fourth option seems right, hold that one. In this nature, generally we don't say that. It was her energetic and friendly nature, that is right. This church was built in the nature of, that is not correct. So what is the answer here? Manner is a word. It goes with all the three sentences. Shall I move on to the next one? Today I don't see a lot of students. It's almost, what could be the reason? Elections. And also, when is your exam? Day after tomorrow. Fine. Question number 14. She retired from the company after 34 years of. There are some problems, this paper. Will you say service or services? Please strike off the letter S. The lawyers offer their service or services? Here you say the lawyers offer their services. Here it should be services. Third one, students go to health services for medical attention. That is also right. We'll see the first one. She retired from the company after 34 years of tenure. Please underline that word, put a star mark, write the meaning of the word tenure. Tenure means what? The period, the time period. A person works, a person rules, time period. The lawyers offer their tenure, that is not right. Students go to the health tenure, that is also not right. So mark this wrong. Already we have considered the second option. Third one, she retired from the company after 34 years of management. Seems okay, we'll check other sentences. The lawyers offer their management. Is it right? Not right. Students go to health management. Not correct. Now, fourth one. She retired from the company after 34 years of work. This seems acceptable. The lawyers offer their work. Their work doesn't sound right. Students go to health work. Not at all right. So, reject that one. Option. She retired from the company after 34 years of option. No. The lawyers offer their option or their options. Okay. Students go to health options, not correct. So what is the answer based on that? The second option is the answer. Question number 15. This scandal, underline the word scandal. Scandal means what? A controversial incident which involves a person swindling money or embezzlement of money has brought the whole enterprise into lasting way. This is a bit difficult. Discredit. Discredit means what? losing the credibility, getting bad name. And which part of speech is discredit in this sentence? If you have to use the word discredit, which part of speech is it? Please make a note, noun. The prosecution, he said we can change the form of the word. The prosecution discredit or discredited. Please write the form. The prosecution discredited the witness by showing that she had lied in the past. Discredited. The verb form has to be changed. Here it is a verb. To our discredit, we failed to offer help when it was most needed. So here, what is it? Discredit? Noun. Okay. This seems right. Hold that one. We'll check third option. One is not right. Third option is what? Indefinite. So this scandal has brought the whole enterprise into lasting indefinite. Does it make any sense? Mark it wrong. This scandal has brought the whole enterprise into lasting disregard. Seems acceptable. Hold that one. The prosecution disregarded the witness. Disregarded the witness by showing that she had lied in the past. Seems okay. To our disregard, does it sound right? No. So please mark it wrong. Notice. This scandal has brought the whole enterprise into lasting notice. Does it sound right? Not at all. The prosecution notice the witness. That is also not right. To our notice, not at all right. So what is the answer here? Discredit is the answer. But the form has to be changed a few sentences. Have we done with all the five sentences? How do you find these, easy or difficult? Rather easy, should not be a problem. Now we'll move on. Questions 16 to 20. What do they deal with? Spot the error. One error or more than one error? Only one. Fine. A group of youngsters, please underline the word group. Which part of speech is it? Is it singular or plural? Singular or plural? Singular. A group of youngsters has lent financial assistance, I'll read out the sentence, to the flood-affected people of the villages. Now my first question, where is the error? What is the error? Is it has lent or has lent? Which tense is this? Present perfect. So, please excuse me for a minute. Jump in. So, please underline. Lend is not right. Change it to. And make a note, the question is related to present perfect tense. Present perfect tense. Underline the expression flood affected. In many bank exams, they give questions related to affect and effect. Write those two words. What is the word affect? Which part of speech is it? Please write the part of speech. Which part of speech is it? Verb. Then write the word effect. Looks like we have a problem. Please make a note. There was no problem yesterday, surprisingly. So effect, which part of speech is it? Noun. Please make a note. So whenever you come across a particular word, sentence, think of other words also, recollect the related rules. Shall I move on to the next one? So what is the question number? Question number 17. If you want to ensure prompt, is it 17 or 16? 17. If you want to ensure prompt service, please have contact LIS as soon as possible. So where is the error? What is the error? Please have what? Or please contact. So what is redundancy here? Strike off the word. I am scared to touch this, but please strike off the word have. Then what do you get? Please contact. Easy one or difficult one? Easy. Shall I move on to the next one? Please make a note next to the question, right? A redundancy. What is the spelling of the word redundancy? Have you written? Fine. Question number 18. The list of candidates admitted to the test should be remain with the invigilator during the test. Where is the error? What is it? Should be remain or should be remained? Or should remain? I will give the choice now. Is it should remain or should be remained? Who says the first one should remain? Raise your hands. That is right. Here it should be in active voice. So what is the error here? Strike off the word be. The list, what is the subject here? Please underline the word the list. The list of candidates admitted to the test should remain. The list should remain with the whatever it is. So please make a note. The question is related to what? Redundancy. Redundancy. Same thing. Shall I move on to the next one? Question number 19. While the issue was no longer as serious as the demise or survival of the company, punctuation problem is there. Please underline the word demise. Demise means what? Death. Write the word death. Demise or survival of the company. The ultimate fate of this national treasure was far off settled. Where is the error? What is the error? Is it far off or far from settled? Please strike off and write. Generally, what do we say? We say far from settled. So what is this question related to? Preposition. Please make a note. Preposition related. Far from settled, a standard expression. If you read the newspapers, you come across this expression. Shall I move on to the next one? Where the default is willful and deliberately, legal steps should be taken promptly after obtaining approval from the appropriate authority. Where is the error? What is it? Is it deliberately or deliberate? Please strike off. Now, which part of speech is it? Should not take so long. Adjective. Write one combination. Deliberate act. Deliberate act. So what does it mean? Act is a noun. Deliberate is adjective. But they have done deliberately. Then which part of speech is deliberately? Adverb. We cannot use, and this question is related to, morning also I was telling one particular batch students, quite often they ask questions, please make a note, the question is related to word form. Word forms are very important. Here we cannot use the adverbial form, we should use the adjective form. Word is the same. So have you made a note? Has anyone got all the five correct? Should be, should not be a surprise. Now we'll move on to the next set of questions. What do they deal with? This is very difficult. How many sentences are there? Six or seven? Seven. And not easy to make out. But there's a pattern in this confusion. What is a pattern? How has the writer presented. Three sentences go with one idea, then two sentences go with a different idea, then again two sentences go with the third idea. So total how many sentences do you get? Seven. We'll see the first three sentences, then we'll move on to the second idea. Here you cannot take the elimination approach, but when you read all the seven sentences, what is this about? You should ask the question. It is about what? Corrupt officials. So which sentence talks about that one? Or what has been going on in the recent past? Are you guys listening? So what is the first sentence? How many of you say B is the first sentence? That's right. So what is it? The surge, underline the word surge. Surge means what? A sudden forward movement, one of the meanings, or sudden increase. The surge in corrupt practices, underline the word practices. Focus the spelling. What is the spelling here? Which part of speech is this? Noun. The surge in corrupt practices among municipal officers has plagued our system for a long time. Please underline the word plagued. Plague is a disease, but in this context, what is the meaning of that particular word? It means it has affected the system. It has disturbed the system. It has spoiled the system. That's what it means. A negative meaning. Please write a negative meaning. The surge in corrupt practices among municipal officers has plagued our system for a long time. Now, what is a clue word for you? Are you guys listening? What is a clue word? The first three sentences, I said, they belong to one particular idea. They go with one word is the key word. What is that? Officers or officials. What is it? Officers or officials. Please underline the word officers. Now, what is the second sentence? Where do you find the word officers? A or E? Both. Officers, officials, one and the same. You see that word in E. Please underline the word officers. Then you underline officials. Now you have to read the sentence very carefully. Now he talks about what is the subject in B, the surge. Underline that. Then you use a pronoun. If it is about officers, will you use a pronoun it? If it is about surge, what is the appropriate pronoun? It. Then we'll check E. It has become next to impossible to get anything done without bribing officers. Underline the word officers and underline the pronoun it. What has become next to impossible? The surge in corrupt practices, it is about that. It has become next to impossible to get anything done without bribing officers. One and two you got. What is one? B. What is two? Now where is the third one? Officials or officer? Obviously A. How does it go? Most officials demand money in exchange for performing even the simplest of tasks. Here he's trying to emphasize. How do the writers emphasize? Or in this sentence, what is the word that goes with emphasis? Underline the word even. One thing is they're corrupt. Obviously they demand money. But what does the writer say? Most officials demand money in exchange for performing even the simplest of tasks. So what is the third sentence? A is the third sentence. So these three go with the practice and the officials. Clear? Then what is the fourth? Fourth and fifth, one idea. What is the fourth sentence? What is it about? If you get fourth, fifth becomes very easy. So what is the fourth sentence? Now generally, corrupt officials are there, corrupt practices are there, and whose job is it to stop that, to put a check? Some organization, some committee, or some particular entity, right? Now based on that, whose job is it? Clearly mentioned, anti-corruption bodies. Now what is the fourth sentence? How many of you have chosen G as a fourth sentence? That's right. I'll read out. most anti-corruption bodies seem to be oblivious. Please underline the word oblivious, an important word. Obvious means what? Clear, evident, can make out. Oblivious, not aware of. Please write. Not aware of. Write one sentence, then you understand. She was oblivious of, she was oblivious of the surroundings. The surroundings. This is what we say generally. Oblivious of what? The surroundings. Means what? She was engrossed in the work. When you get engrossed, you know the word engrossed, in work or reading, you become oblivious of your surroundings. Means not aware of the surroundings. It's an important word. Please put a star mark. So most anti-corruption bodies seem to be oblivious to this practice and often fail to take any steps against it even after receiving a complaint. They seem to be oblivious, one problem, and they don't take action after receiving the complaint, another problem. So what is the sentence number? Fourth one. What is the fourth one? G. Now what is the fifth one? The writer says they don't do that, but instead of that they do something else. So what is the connecting word? Please underline the word instead. F is the next one. Instead, they ignore the matter and in some instances are also complicit in these acts. Complicit means what? They're part of the act. They join hands with corrupt officials. So what is the fifth sentence? F is the fifth sentence. These two sentences go with one idea, the second idea. Now the third idea, two sentences. What is the next one? Easy to make out. You are left with how many sentences? Two sentences. What are they? C and D. You have to decide. It is a pity that people agree to pay bribes for services that they are entitled to. Please underline the word entitled. Entitled to means what? They have the right to have that particular privilege. Entitled to have the right. It is imperative that an inquiry is carried out in this regard and the image of the corporation is improved to instill, underline the word instill, people's faith in the system. Which one is first and which one is second? What is the sixth sentence? Please make a note. Sixth is, C is the sixth one. And what is the last one? D is the last one. Okay. It could be the other way also, but we'll check. This has been taken from a particular news channel. Now see the actual text. Two paragraphs. First paragraph, four sentences, three plus one, three ideas, three sentences, one officials or officers related to that, then the system, and the last two sentences. It is a pity that people agree to pay bribes for services that they are entitled to. What is the last sentence? It is imperative that. So what is the order? C, D. Who has got all the seven correct? Give her a big hand. That's really good. I appreciate. Very tough, very difficult. Now shall we move on? The next set of questions, what do they deal with? Phrasal verbs. So what is the first one? I may need to call on the university's excellent professors in order to answer your question. First, you should understand whether it is right or wrong. On what basis you decide? What is the meaning of the phrasal verb call on? One of the meanings, please write, call on means visit. Please write the meaning, visit. Call on, visit. Shrikant. endukante undu. So please write the meaning of the phrasal verb call on. Call on means what? To visit. So imagine you know the meaning, is it right or wrong? I may need to call on, I may need to visit, right or wrong? Seems right, hold that one. Write the meaning of the phrasal verb call back. Call back. Call back means what? Return a call. Please write, return a call. Then what is the next one? Call off. Call off means what? Cancel. Please write the meaning. Cancel. Generally, you see in the newspaper, they called off the match. Typical sentence. Call up. Call up means what? To call someone. To make a call. Call up. Please write the meaning. To make a call. Hope I'm not going very fast. The last one, call around. Write the meaning. Call around means to call a lot of people. Please write, to call a lot of people, either to give information or get information. Either to give information or get information. So what is the answer for this question number 26? No change required. Generally, if you read the newspapers, please write one sentence. The Prime Minister called on the President. The Prime Minister called on the President. Quite often they use. Means what? The Prime Minister visited the President. All of you, please remember phrasal verbs. I have noticed a lot of students have been asking me, sir, please teach phrasal verbs. In fact, I thought of bringing a 30-minute session of lecture, phrasal verbs. But unfortunately, yesterday I got a call. I was to take the class this morning, 7 to 9. Then I could not work on that. But generally speaking, my advice, if you take bank exams especially, these days they are asking, they started IBPS last year, a lot of questions related to phrasal verbs. And a lot of students are scared, worried, and obviously they're not good at phrasal verbs. Even the native speakers, they're not very good at phrasal verbs. And if you take phrasal verbs, hundreds are there. Can you remember all of them? Not possible. And how do they don't try to learn or mug up phrasal verbs. They pick up from a context. They listen, they pick up. That opportunity you don't have because you don't listen to good English outside. What is the language? Telugu. No one uses English and forget about using phrasal verbs. Another problem. And what is the source? One source you have to read either the newspapers or magazines, or sometimes if you read fiction and non-fiction English novels, especially fiction, and you come across phrasal verbs. But do you have so much time? Is this a time to read English novels? Definitely not. Then they know this. They know your background. I've seen a lot of questions related to phrasal verbs. All that you need, use your grammar knowledge, use your common sense, and use your presence of mind. This is what I've observed. Whether you know the meaning or not, that doesn't matter. But your presence of mind and common sense, you can get out of five, at least three right. Out of 10, at least six right. But once you panic and you see the, oh, phrasal verbs, don't touch, and you switch off, then you will not get easy ones also. Please remember that. You may get on Saturday, be prepared and be happy. Look at the sentences very carefully. See the context. From the context, you can make out. Grammar knowledge, you can make out. Try to do that. Shall I move on to the next one? So what is question number 27? What is the context? Aeroplanes. There were no delays. The plane touched at exactly on time. Now first, is this right or wrong? Mark it wrong. Before you do that, please underline the expression on time. What is the meaning of the expression on time? Exact time. Before time, what is the expression? Please write in time. Generally, we are not in time, we are not on time, we are after the time. Generally, I said, I'm not talking, we always have exceptions. I know a lot of students are very punctual. I'm very careful when I talk. I use words like usually, generally. Then sometimes I see the faces of the students, immediately I say, exceptions are there. Because some of them look at me very seriously. So what is the context? It is all about the flights, aeroplanes. And you say it is wrong, mark it wrong. You're right that way. Please mark it wrong. Strike it off. Now, common sense, if you are good at English and you know the context, what is the context? The flight touched the ground. So what are the options? Touch up. Touch up, is it right or wrong? Okay, touch on. No. Touch down. From above, down. So what is the answer here? Touched down. Grammatically also it is right. Touched upon. Now please write the meanings of other phrasal verbs. First you write touch up. Please write touch up means what? Touch up means what? To touch something. Then to improve. Please write to improve. That is one meaning. And write one more meaning. Quick improvement. Quick improvement. And this goes with brackets, you write appearance. Slight touch up here and there. It may go with faces, it may go with buildings, it may go with anything, touch up. You all know that, I don't have to tell. Okay. Now what is the second one? Please make a note, touch on and touched upon. Don't consider the verb form, consider the phrase, the preposition. Touch on, touch upon, write the meaning. To refer to or to mention. He touched upon the new subject. He touched on the new subject. Means what? He mentioned, he referred, he said something about that. That's it. Shall I move on to the next one? So what is the next one? Question number 28. What is it? First one is touch up. Touch down, you're asking? No, 1 minute. Touch at. No, there is no meaning. Touch at. Or perhaps it is like he has touched at some point. He has touched at some point. But generally we don't use it. So, oh, your doubt is that. Touched at. No. So, shall I move on to the next one? What is the next sentence? What is it about? Crazy kids. The title should be Crazy Kids. The kids put the cat in the oven. It is not oven. Usually Indians say oven. It is oven. It is not onion. It is onion. If you go to a shop and say, I want onions, he will look at you. What is he talking about? He doesn't know English. But what is the correct pronunciation? Onion, not onion. Oven, not oven. So, the kids put the cat in the oven because it was cold. That's why they are kids. What are they going to think in next? First, is it right or wrong? Mark it wrong. This is a bit difficult. What are they going to think over, think on, think around, think up? Which one seems right? Your gut feeling. How many of you think the fourth option? That is the answer. Think up. Write the meaning of that. There is no meaning for think in. I cross-checked. First, we'll start with that one. Think in, no combination. Then you write the meaning of think up. Means to think of something quickly. First meaning. To think of something quickly. also right to invent, I-N-V-E-N-T, invent, to invent something, to think of something quickly. So what is it? Think up. Then you write the meaning of think over. Think over means what? To consider something before you take the decision. Please write the meaning. Shock. Think over, please write, consider seriously before you take a decision. Have you written? Then you write the meaning of think on. Think on means think of or think about someone or something. Think of or think about, of or about someone or something. Think around. There are two meanings. One meaning, to express personal opinion. Think around. One meaning, to express personal opinion. The second one, to think differently. Think around a concept. To think out of the box. To think differently. This goes with expressing your views, related to your views. There's a problem with the question number 29. Shall I move on to the next one? A young man made fur with my briefcase while I was checking the timetable. First, is it right or wrong? If you look at the grammar part, is it right or wrong? Grammar. Any other option that goes with grammar knowledge? That is a problem with this question. But please mark it wrong. Made fur. Generally, what do we say? Please write one expression. That will be very useful in future. Made for each other. Oh, you're all so happy. They are made for each other. Now that is not right. Forget about grammar. Keep it aside. What is the first one? Make over. Make over means what? To improve something. Please write the meaning. To improve. Make over. Complete transformation. Also write transformation. Complete makeover. The answer is actually the second option. But the verb form has to be changed. This sentence is in which tense, present or past? Past. So make of is not correct. Please change it to made of. Now I'll read out the sentence. A young man made off with my briefcase while I was checking the timetable. Made off. Write the meaning. To escape, one meaning. To move away quickly, another meaning. Generally, it goes with escape. Disappear. Also write the word, to disappear quickly. Now write one sentence. The thieves made off with the money. Made off with the money before the police arrived. Please correct it, the first part. The thieves had made off. Add the word had. The thieves had made off with the money before the police arrived. Means what? They escaped or they disappeared. Make do with, I don't think it is right. As far as my knowledge goes, please don't consider the third option. Make do with. Make off means what? Consist of. Comprise. It is made of something. It consists of something. Please write the sentence. It is made of plastic. Easy one. Easy to make out. Shall I move on to the next one? The horses were enclosed in a paddock, but a few of them managed to break away. Right? Don't look at me like that. You have to respond. Right, wrong, sir, we have to see the options. What? Right or wrong? Correct or incorrect? Incorrect. Please mark it. What is the meaning? Please write the meaning of break away. This, if you read the newspapers, you come across quite often. Please write break away means. First, you write the combination words. Administrative units. Administrative units. States. States. S-T-A-T-E-S. Unions. Union, singular, unions. Now you write the meaning. To get separated. To get separated. Break away. Now write the sentence, you understand. The militants, you know the word militants. The militants wanted Jammu and Kashmir. You could write the letters J and K. The militants wanted Jammu and Kashmir to break away from India. Break away from India. Means what? To get separated from India. Now you got the meaning. What is the first one? Now what is the answer for this? Breakaway is not correct. You can make out from the context. How many of you have chosen the first option? Break free. That is the answer. Which one have you chosen? Third one, break into. No, I will tell the meaning. Not at all. Please make a note. What is the answer here? Break free. Break free means what? You're not tied. You're a free bird. What is the expression? Free bird means what? No restrictions. Now we'll see the other options. Please write the word or the phrasal verb, break down. Breakdown has got two or three meanings, but two meanings are in usage, very popular. Please write the first meaning. Breakdown means stop working. Stop working. And write the combination words. Please write vehicles, write power, write system. Also write machine. Generally, everyday English, we use it with car, bus, all these vehicles. So write one sentence. The car broke down yesterday. The car broke down yesterday. Means what? The car stopped working yesterday. The machine breaks down regularly. You can make out. Write the second meaning of breakdown. Breakdown also means to collapse emotionally. To collapse. Collapse emotionally. Imagine you go to an old lady, you tell her shocking news. What will happen? She'll collapse emotionally. Then what do you say? The old lady broke down when she heard the shocking news. So please write the sentence. The old lady broke down when she heard the shocking news. What is the last one? Break off. Break off has got two different meanings. Write the first meaning. Oh, I'm sorry, break into. Break into, please write break into. Before I tell break into, please write break in. First you write break in. Break in means interrupt. Please write interrupt. If I'm busy talking, someone wants to interrupt, then what do I say? Please don't break in while I'm talking. Don't break in while the lecture is on. Got the meaning? Now you write the phrasal verb break into. Break into means to enter by force. To enter by force. And write the combination words. This goes with thieves. police, sometimes individuals also. But generally it goes with thieves. Now write the meaning. What is the meaning of that? To enter by force. Have you written? Enter by force. Now write one example. A thief broke into my neighbor's house last night. A thief broke into my neighbor's house last night. What does it mean? He entered by force. Hope you got the meaning. So this is not the answer. Now what is the next one? Please write break off. Break off has got two different meanings. Please write the first meaning. Break off means to get separated. To get separated. We also use one expression. Please write this. This is a better expression. I'm really sorry. Today some problem is there with this. Yesterday there was no problem. It went off very smoothly, but somehow. Please write snap off. I will dictate. S-N-A-P, snap off, O-F-F. Snap off means what? To get separated, to come off, snap off. This is the first meaning. Write the second meaning. Break off means stop talking. Stop talking. Someone all of a sudden stops talking. Then what do you say? She broke off. You got it? Fine. Is that the last one? Please say yes or no. I'm not going to touch the passage today. Don't ask me why. Some more questions are there? Or except passage, we have done all other questions. I'm going to spend a few minutes. When is your exam? Tomorrow it is a holiday. You all must be knowing that. Day after tomorrow, you will not come. That means whatever we can discuss or whatever I can say, we have about 10 minutes. We'll use that. Now, at this stage, what is your gut feeling? Exam is going to be easy or difficult? You're going to rock, or the exam is going to rock you? So what is your idea, what is your attitude, what is your feeling? You're going to rock. That's right. But generally, apprehensions, you may have a lot of apprehensions. What is the meaning of the word apprehension?